I just don't want y'all to go bashing Chris.
Wait,
just
huh?
Because me and him had
Wait,
issues.
Hold on.
Don't mean he's
sorry. Okay. God damn it, Laisha, you always fucking up.
Ugh. Don't let fear keep you from doing what you love. Oh my God, what is up, everybody? It's your girl Laisha Maurice, and this is my first video of 2018. Yikes, I'm real late. This video was supposed to happen a long time ago, but because of some technical difficulties, because y'all know me and my anger issues, I had to get myself together before I could, you know, get on that road. But that's neither here nor fucking there. Today, you guys, I am bringing you a reaction and some commentary. This is more of a commentary than really it is a reaction. I know there's been like a lot of Chris and Queen drama going on YouTube, and I've been avoiding it simply so I can make this video. We're probably gonna be like a two-parter, maybe. I'm gonna start out with Queen's side of the story because that's who I like the most. No shade, but shade. And just see how everything pans out. She has a song out called Medicine, and then there's a video explaining why she left Chris. So without further ado, let's hop right into this reaction to Medicine.
You tell me you love me, but I ain't been feeling it lately. You say you love keeping me fly, but can't keep me from looking so crazy. Coming at 6 in the morning, where you been? Who is that texting your phone? Just a friend.
Okay.
My intuition never lies. There's nothing you can never hide. Already got the screenshot, so there is no need to deny. You've been creeping and freaking and sneaking like you never lose me. Steady claiming that everyone know we together, but you steady choosing. Swear I cannot win for losing. I've been out here being faithful. I always got this on lockdown, but that ain't been keeping us stable. So I guess I know what I gotta do. Give you a taste of your own medicine. Hey, yeah. How would you like it if I do the things you do?
Put you Wait a minute, not- Queen, why you snapping like this, shorty? Wait. I wasn't ready. No, I wasn't ready. Hold on. Why are you snapping like this? Yo. And I've always been one to say, yo, I just want Queen to focus on her music. Like, fuck this YouTube shit. But, like, I got my fucking wish. Yo, shorty is snapping. She's snapping. You know, actually, no. Fuck that. We're gonna continue.
Disturbing, entertain these dudes. I'ma ride them crazy, and you never have a clue. Give another guy everything that belongs to you. I'ma call up Brian. I'ma FaceTime Ryan. I'ma text Lorenzo, and I'ma leave.
I said I was gonna stop. I'm sorry.
Don't get it twisted. I can play this game too. How would you like it if I did the same to you? Yeah. telling me that I should fight it. Why you be out here playing a victim when I am the one who been crying? Why this shit up, I can't take it. I want revenge, I can't fake it. Wanna see the look on your face when I drop my clothes and I get naked. Not for you, but for him. Now tell me, player, how does it make you feel? How could you play me when the love I gave was real? I even took you back and you still had no chill. Boy, you ain't gon' never learn. Play with fire, you get burned. I don't think you'll understand till I hit you where it hurts, yeah. So I guess I know what I gotta do. Give you a taste of your own.
Give him a taste, girl. She is snapping.
Crazy and you never have a clue. Give another guy everything that belongs to you. I'ma call up Ryan. I'ma FaceTime Ryan. I'ma text Lorenzo and I'ma leave you crying. Don't get it twisted. I can play this game too. How would you like it if I did the same to you? Same to you, yeah. All of those tears.
Okay. Come through, queen.
I turned into a savage boy, don't ask me why.
Girl, hold on, I'm gonna hit that thumbs up real quick. All right.
Ask me why.
Yo.
Don't ask me why.
Queen. I'm not even, listen, I know the rest of this song is straight runs, and it has to be. It's only 20 seconds left. But yo, you ain't have to snap like that, shorty. Yo, that's crazy. You didn't have to snap like that. I don't. You know what? You know what, queen? You know what, m'lady? You know what? You didn't have to snap like that. Like that, I did. That's all I have. You did not have to snap like that. This song is dope as fuck. Like, that's something I'd play. As like my little warning part two, because everybody knows if y'all hear Trey Songz cheat on you, that is my warning song to whatever nigga is getting on my nerves. So this might be a part, this might be part two. Hold on, I fucks with it. Damn, you ain't have to snap like that, shorty. Like, damn, I am simply amazed. Like, I'm at a loss for words. I didn't expect it to be like that. That is an anthem. Like, you did the damn thing. I respect it. And that is something that I've been wanting out of you for a very, 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 very long time. I've been saying for so long that I just want Queen to focus on her music. Fuck all this other shit. Focus on the music. Same thing with Armand and Trey. Focus on your music. I don't care about the drama, the pranks. The vlogs are interesting, but focus on your music. You are talented as fuck. Focus on your music. And I'm glad that that's what you're doing right now. It's amazing. I would hope for more bangers like this, because listen, I'm trying to have an EP by the end of the year. I'm trying to have an EP by the end of the year. I flex with it. That's something I can rock to. That's clean. I like it. So now, there is a video on her channel that she posted on her reasons why her and Chris aren't together anymore. So we're gonna jump right into that in a second. But I've been actually watching her social media like a hawk. So here are some screenshots that, you know, led up to the video I'm about to watch. So you guys can look at that.
Don't want y'all to go bashing Chris. Just because me and him had issues don't mean that he's not a good person.
Wait. Oh. Huh? I agree. No, it doesn't.
You should just be yourself.
You should just be yourself. What's up, Rosie Squad? It's your girl, Queen Minika, once again back with another video. And today, this is not a vlog. This is not a challenge. This is not a prank on somebody. This is me just simply coming to y'all and just talking to y'all as if we were in the same room. I just really want to clear up a lot of things, you know. I dropped a song 2 days ago called Medicine. If y'all haven't heard it, make sure you guys go listen to it because it's self-explanatory. It pretty much explains everything I felt and the reason why I actually did leave. I left the house and I did leave Chris. We are legally married and we're working on documents and all that stuff to officially, you know, separate. And I know that sounds heartbreaking to a lot of people because we were looked up to, like, as relationship goals. Like, we was that deal, we was that couple that everybody wanted to be like. I mean, some of y'all didn't really want to, but majority of people looked up to me and Chris. We was on the road, like, it was me and him. When you seen Chris, you seen me.
Facts.
But, you know, sometimes stuff happens in your relationship when everything is just so public and you don't have no privacy and people are constantly throwing themselves at you and, like, everything just coming at you at once. Sometimes stuff just happens. So I am pretty sure you guys know about the whole thing that happened in September, the whole Helena situation.
That was in September? Damn.
Chris, I guess, had got caught cheating. And, you know, that was really tough on me, y'all. Like, that was tough. Like, it hurt bad. And to be honest with y'all, I still haven't healed from that. Like, I haven't. But nevertheless, I decided to stay and I decided to push through and just see if my family could work because this is what I wanted. Like, this is what I wanted forever. Through all of that, it's like I was getting called dumb, weak. I was getting called every name in the book. I just had so much heat coming at me for staying with him. People started to think it was fake and it was just a scandal. You know, so it was a lot going on. But nevertheless, I decided to push through and I decided to stay, you know? And I just felt like that was my business. And if anything else ever happened, then it would be my decision, you know, to do whatever I wanted to do. After I stayed, you know, we would do videos and sometimes I wouldn't look as happy. And
you can tell. You can definitely tell.
But I was trying to be happy. And I was still gonna push through it no matter what. I was gonna heal and I was gonna. Well, I already did. I forgave him and everything. And I just feel like people make mistakes and stuff like that. But even in that, it's like when I did find out that whole situation.
Hold on, pause before I even let her finish. You could definitely tell in the videos, especially when they did that Hurt Bae thing. You can tell she was completely over it. She didn't want to be in that situation. Like, you could just tell. And he looked like he was kind of like happy, but you could tell she was faking it. Like, you could really tell. Even when, like, he went and he changed, like, the name of their channel, you could tell that that was real, that he really went out and he did that. And then once, like, he saw that the views and shit was dropping, he was like, you know what, I'm gonna change it back and I'm gonna say it's a prank, and Queen, we need to stage this and let everybody think, you know, it's a prank type shit. Because you could just tell. You can literally tell, like, that something was going on. And even after, what, Thanksgiving, when you can tell she was gone. Like, she left the house. And because she was always at Armand, Trey, and Jazz's house. You can tell that something wasn't right. But I'm going to, you know, let her finish. You can catch me in Martin Lewis's comments talking about how I feel about this. But, you know, just gonna let Queen finish.
It's like, it wasn't just that. It was more. So, I was taking on a lot more than what people thought. But I'm not going to really go into detail about that. But anyway, I stayed. And afterwards, you know, it just began to become like this repetitive cycle. I'm not a person that go out and like expose stuff and say, oh, well, this happened. I'm not the type of person to do that. But it started to become like a repetitive cycle. And even on like the blog, the drama blog pages, I would see even after that, like, you know, footage of, you know, him at the club and stuff, dancing with girls. And this was like after it. So stuff just was like not really going the way I wanted it to go. I know stuff takes time. I know trust takes time. I know all of that. But it was a reason why I left. I didn't just leave for no reason.
Facts.
I just seen a video, I guess, that Chris had, he was freestyling or whatever. It got deleted, but you know, he said that I had cheated on him, which is not true. I don't know if he's talking about, like, because before we started YouTube, we separated before YouTube because we was having issues even then, and I felt neglected, and I felt, it was just a lot of reasons, you know. He would go out all the time, and I just felt like our relationship was falling apart. I wasn't getting the attention I needed. I didn't trust him. I felt like, you know, it was girls in the picture, and so somebody came along and entertained me, and I guess that's what he called cheating. But anyway, after that, after we started YouTube, like...
See, and that's the problem with men. Men can do so much to us and expect us to take it and stay, but as soon as we even step our big toe outside the door for some fresh air, they can't take it. And it's several trust issues on trust issues on trust issues on their half, when in reality they're the ones that's fucking up. So if he really took that as that,
and just was on a roll. I never had spoke to anyone else. Like, I never gave nobody the time of day. Like, you would never catch me with no screenshots with nobody, like how you did him. I don't wanna cause no unnecessary beef because I still gotta talk to him off camera, but I just wanna let y'all know, you know, it's a reason why I left, and that reason is because things were just repetitive. On and off arguments and stuff like that, and I just couldn't deal with it. And I would go into detail about exactly what happened, but I'd rather not, because it would just cause even more friction. Just know that us females never just do stuff for no reason. We never just leave for no reason.
No, we're not gonna skip past that. Where is it? Not to mention, the last hickey on his neck was not from me. Trifling.
It would just cause even more friction. Just know that us females never just do stuff for no reason. We never just leave for no reason. Best believe is always something, because when I love,
that's trifling.
I love hard, you know. And I might,
you're married,
the perfect wife, but I was loyal, you know. I was loyal. I may not have cooked all the time, and half of the time we was never at home, or he would be out with his friends all the time. So, you know, I'm not really using that as an excuse, but that's just the truth. At the same time, you guys, I really just thought about it, and Chris is 22, I'm 22. We both young, like, and I started to think that I was older. I started feeling like I was 30 years old because of stress and stuff like that, losing weight and all that stuff. Like, I just felt like I was older than what I was, and I had to sit back and realize, like, wow, I'm 22. Me and Chris got married at 19. We was,
God bless it,
so in love. Like, I wasn't ready to be married, y'all. Like, I wasn't, but I just wanted to do it the right way because I had a baby on the way, and we just was so in love, and we was going to church, and we didn't want to be looked at as, like, you know, we're shacking up. We wanted to live together without shacking up, and, you know, we just wanted to do it the right way. But honestly, I don't feel like Chris was ready. Maybe he felt like he was ready at the time. And I know that I wasn't ready, because I went straight from being in my mom's house up under her rules to being married and being up under, you know, a man's rules, you know? And I never really got that chance to go out, venture out, and, like, find myself. I never really dated around like that. I mean, high school was like kiddie relationships. I never went to college anything like that. I thought I never really had that time to just go out and focus on Queen. It's always been somebody else in the picture, and it's always been Chris in the picture. You know what I'm saying? And I always thought about him too. And I just feel like after everything that happened, like, I'm pretty much broken now, and I don't think that I could take, you know, much more. Because it wasn't just cheating that was going on. It was like a lot of disagreements we had, like about, you know, our families and money and stuff like that. And it just wasn't.
All right. I just was just hoping she wasn't going to confirm what her sister was saying.
Sometimes things happen in life and you think you're going to be with somebody forever. And if it's meant to be, it will come back together. But you think you got this plan, like, oh, we're going to be together forever. But stuff just don't work out. You know, sometimes people get sidetracked. You know, he had a lot of women throwing themselves at him. It was a plenty, like, girls out the butt just throwing themselves at him. Like, because he had that platform. He was big. He's a very handsome guy. So, I mean, he had a lot of temptation, and he just wasn't able to resist it, you know? And I had temptation, too, but just not as much as him. Because it seemed like girls are more thirsty. Like, guys, they'll see that you're in a relationship and you on lockdown.
That's not true.
But girls, like, that's they not don't true. Care. They don't care if you're married or whatever. Like, they'll still come at you. And maybe it got hard for him, you know? But I told him that, you know, if that's what you want to do, that's fine. Because I get it, you're still young. But just not with... I just thought that it would be better to... call it quits. And I know that sounds sad, but I need to go find myself, and I would like to do whatever I want to do, honestly.
Facts.
I'm just at a point now where that's how I feel. I don't want to have to answer to nobody. I don't want to have to worry about who over here, who over there, who you texting, and all of this stuff. I just feel like it would be a lot better, you know, if I just focus on myself and had friends, pretty much. That's it. That's really the conclusion of my video. One more thing, I just don't want y'all to go bashing Chris. Just because me and him had issues, don't mean that he's not a good person. You feel me? Like, he's still a good person, you know? He's a wonderful dad, he's a wonderful father. So, you know, make sure you guys still go show him love on a Daddy and Me channel, because at the end of the
damn,
day, no matter what,
damn, wait. She didn't even say go show him love on the Chris and Queen channel. She said go show him love on the Daddy and Me channel. Shady.
CJ still loves him. He's still a good father to CJ, and I won't take that away from him. But sometimes things just don't work out between, you know, the relationship. So that's all I can really say. But I love you guys, and I hope you guys can respect my decision. I'm going to stay humble. Like, it's in me. Like, I have no other option but to stay humble. No matter how far I go up, it's always because
facts.
Of God. And it's always because
facts.
Of my supporters. You guys and God. No, God and you guys, in that order. I'm going to go ahead and end this video. And I hope y'all understood everything I was trying to say. Once again, medicine is self-explanatory. So go listen to it, go read over the lyrics, and you guys will get a good understanding.
Okay, so that was that. I personally feel as though she has the right to feel that the way she does. She is a woman. We are, I don't know how to put it. We are very sensitive creatures. We do things sometimes without thinking. Like, I know a lot of women out there can say that their men have cheated and they have stayed, and to the point where they couldn't take it anymore. And being that their relationship was so public and things like that, you know, it does stress you out a little bit more because you're not doing it by yourself. You're doing it in front of millions of people. So, I commend her on leaving. I personally wasn't one of those people who thought that she was dumb for staying. Because I've been in that situation before. And, it is what it is. At the end of the day, you can either stick it out and try and make it work, or you can leave. And she tried to make it work. It didn't work. So she left. There's nothing to it. So, I mean, I 100% respect Queen. I enjoy her channel by herself more than their joint channel, anyway. I'm just glad that, you know, she's finding her worth at this time. So, with that being said, follow me on all of my social media, Twitter.com/LaishaMauriceX3, Instagram BlueRebelX3, Twitch LaishaMauriceX3. We just got our affiliate over there, so go over there and subscribe so you can get a wonderful emote of me making a crazy ass face and enjoy some gameplay. If you guys are ever wondering why I'm so absent from YouTube, Twitch is usually where I am, or you guys can join the Discord. There's always going to be a Discord link in the description box down below. And I guess now we're gonna go see Chris's side of, you know, this whole breakup thing. So I'll see you guys in my next video. Peace.